37 jabs per round. The third most active of all fighters. So it's the cornerstone of his attack. We'll see how well we can use it here.
Huge size difference for Magsayo, who again, dramatic come from behind knockout win over Julio Cejado. Earned mandatory status. He knocked Cejado down in the first round, then knocked him out in the 10th, but he went down in the 5th, so overcame his own adversity in that fight.
And Cejado had a good body attack in that fight. Russell's not known as a body puncher, so Magsayo has to worry too much about that. This stuff that I've seen from Magsayo, he definitely wants to control of this fight early on. Make Rusell remember that he's been inactive for 2 years. And how do you do that? Well, be first. Remind him that, hey, he's not as easy coming back after 2 years.
But if anyone has proven that they can bounce back from extremely long breaks, it's Mr. Garry Rusell. The gym rat who stays busy by training his brothers. He serves as their chief second. Hey, from the Rusell family, boxing is life.
Yeah, he's the master at not showing any ring rust. You know, Magsayo, the uppercut is becoming a weapon that Magsayo really wants to try and get in there. He's working it pretty well against the shoulder side.
And Magsayo countering the counter puncher.
Also, they make you Rusell reach. That's one thing.
I'll step up.
Which power punch will Rusell pass?
Garry Rusell Jr. less than 30 seconds left in the first.
What's Rusell trying to land here? Zane said Magsayo people think when he reaches with that punch, he came in with the right hand. And there he tried to... Very early, but Mr. Magsayo, you want a good start.
The uppercut for him in round number one. Maybe an early